Just a disclaimer, I'm not an expert in anything Android. I have an Android phone as my secondary phone and I mostly use it for the basic stuff like calls, messaging, and playing Mobile Legends, so I don't really know much about it. But I'm sharing this with you because I felt the disappointment of those who want to play custom songs but don't own a PC. For the past 2 days, I've been tinkering with this Android app that I use to sideload BMBF. BMBF is the app we need for the custom songs. I'm not gonna say that this doesn't come with risks because like I said, I don't know much about Android. But everything went well for me and no damage was done. If you do the same exact thing as I'll show you in this video, everything should be good. Just prepare the needed cable. If your phone uses micro USB, you can use an adapter. If it's a Type-C like the Quest, you can try the Quest charging cable. I tried it, but this is what happened. It kept disconnecting. So even though my phone is also a Type-C, I had to use an adapter. And the USB 3 to USB-C that I've been using for SideQuest. I don't want to make this video longer than it should be, so let's get started. Step 1. Using the link in the description, log into the Oculus website and create an organization. Just pick any name, only you can see it. Step 2. Using the Oculus app on your phone or tablet, enable developer mode. Step 3. Open your internet browser and go to bmbf.dev/stable and download the latest APK. The latest is always the first APK you see. Don't scroll too far down because it will lead you to the old versions, and installing an outdated version will cause Beat Saber to crash. Step 4. Open Play Store and install Bug Jaeger. Tap on the Packages folder. Step 5. Connect your Quest to your phone and allow USB debugging. This is what I'm using. When your phone detects your Quest, you'll see this prompt. Choose OK. Now the Quest is connected, but you won't be able to do anything yet until you enable USB debugging. Put on your headset and you'll see this. Click Always Allow and then OK. Now check the prompt on your phone. Tap on Bug Jaeger and then just once or always. It's up to you, but I chose just once. If the white area is still blank, just swipe down to refresh the page. If the pop-ups don't appear, disconnect the cable from both ends and reconnect. If that doesn't work, try a different cable. Step 6. Back up your scores. This is optional so you can proceed to step 7 if you want. In Bug Jaeger, click the Files folder in one of the icons above. Scroll down to the SD card folder. Open it and scroll up to the Android folder. Tap on Android, then Data. Scroll down and find the Beat Saber folder. Tap on Files and save these two files in your phone. Double check if the two files are already saved. So the first one wasn't saved because it was asking for permission earlier, so I'm gonna try that again. Step 7. Sideload BMBF. We will now install the file we downloaded in Step 3 to the Quest. Go back to Packages folder and click this button. Select APK file and then OK. BMBF is now in our Quest, so we can now remove the cable. Step 8. Open BMBF on your headset and follow the on-screen instructions. In your apps, click the drop-down box where it says All and scroll down to Unknown Sources. Click BMBF and follow the on-screen instructions. Then click Done. Step 9. Download songs. After clicking Done, you will be redirected to the browser tab. And here, you can download songs by simply clicking the Download button. The number of queued downloads is seen beside the cloud-like icon. Since you're doing this on your headset, it would be best to make use of the menu bar, the search bar, and the search filters to easily find what you're looking for. If you spam download on a song that's already on queue, BMBF will say that it failed, but that only applies to the ones following the first. BMBF doesn't save duplicates, which is convenient for us. In the Playlist tab, you can edit the name of your playlists, make more of them, and delete them. You can delete songs and move songs from one playlist to another. When you're done, click Sync to Beat Saber to save the changes. You won't see your custom songs in-game if you miss this step. You have an option to open Beat Saber through BMBF, but it's not advisable because it will not let you take a screenshot and record your gameplay if you open it through BMBF or if BMBF is running in the background. So go to Tools and click Exit BMBF. Step 10. Enable Storage Permission. In your apps, hover on Beat Saber and click on the three dots. Click Permissions and enable Storage. You can now play Beat Saber, but if you did step 6, continue to step 11. This message will appear every time you open Beat Saber. Just click Open App. Exit Beat Saber on your headset first if it's open. In this step, you'll have to connect your Quest to your phone again and open the Bug Jaeger app. In the Files folder, go to the same location as when you saved the two files in step 6. Click this button to upload the two files you saved. Click it again to upload the other one. We have just replaced our Beat Saber data with the data files containing our high scores. If you did it successfully, congratulations! You can now experience the best of Beat Saber. If not, leave a comment and I'll try to answer it. Before I end this video, I just need to mention the black screen, which is very common. If you keep getting it when you open Beat Saber, just watch this video I linked down below. Have a nice weekend and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this to whoever might benefit from it.